Analytic research, focus on experiments. So in this short video, we're going to review and go a little bit more in depth into how we would to understand experiments a little more. So key features of true experiments, remember, experiments are the gold standard of research. Investigator controls the level of exposure. So remember, the investigator is active. Right, so the keyword is, randomization into treatment control groups controls for potential differences between groups. Okay, so randomization is not the same as random sampling. And so these are called randomized control trials. So random assignment, that's the randomization that we were just talking about. You get into the treatment group, control group. The treatment is administered, so the control group can also be placebo. Or it could be treatment B. Treatment A, okay. So first observation, so this is 1A, 1B, if you want to talk about treatment A, treatment B. You get the treatment, and then observation 2A or 2B. So this is a little bit different map. Now, this is reference population, so that's just another word for source or target population. So this is the experimental population or the sample. And this group, the non-participants, are the ones that decided not to consent or were excluded. So this is the sample A, and this is maybe the sample B. This you want to be as small as possible, because you want to get as, when you're taking a random sample from a population, you want these two to be as close to the same people as possible. Treatment allocation, well, you randomize into a treatment group or control group, so again, treatment A, treatment B, and then these people are removed. This is missing data. The non-compliers are the ones that drop out of the study. Here's a couple of variations. So one-shot pretest post-test design, we looked at this last semester, so there's no treatment group. So control group is not possible. And so this could be for something like a pilot study. And four-group experiment controls from pretest as a confounding variable. So this group gets, this is the pretest, so pretest yes, yes, no, no. So if you want to think about that, you need to think about this as the pretest group, if that you can understand this one. And so, the pretest, this would make sense if you're doing something like in education, for example, taking a test gets your brain thinking about or learning about the topic at hand, not just the treatment and the teaching approach. Subtypes: new drug trials, crossover trials, simple versus factorial. So these are more subtypes. New drug trials are the same as clinical, also known as clinical trials. We study effectiveness and side effects, so there's two outcomes. Various outcomes. So you can see effectiveness and side effects. Crossover trials, subjects switch groups, so we've talked about that one last year too. So treatment group becomes a placebo group. The placebo group becomes a treatment group to see whether the drug has a continued effect. Simple versus factorial. Simple, only one treatment is administered. Factorial, more than one treatment is administered. And then we're going to look at combined effects. So imagine, you know, multivitamins versus single vitamin. And then there's like many possible multiple factors here. So, not a big deal, but you just got to keep in mind those are possible. Experimental studies, more subtypes, preventative versus therapeutic. So that's no big deal. This is just therapeutic means you're getting somebody to improve their health, and preventative means you're trying to prevent, of course. So prophylactic agent is given. Experimental studies, more subtypes, individual versus community. So you can do an ecological experiment. So this is basically an ecological experiment. And these are very rare. So putting fluoride in water in city A and not putting it in city B to see how the various effects of fluoride. So recruitment, that's getting the population. Randomization means selecting, putting people to different groups, collecting data we've talked about in a previous course. And analysis of data. Random sampling is rarely possible. You know that already. You need to have a sample that represents a target population. You don't have to do random sampling for that, but it's a lot more work. Use inclusion criteria to... This is for creating the target population. So if your drug is supposed to help people with heart disease, then you don't want people in your study who do not have heart disease. So inclusion-exclusion criteria, that's what we're doing that for. And sample size, again, sampling design, and informed consent. Those are all part of recruitment. Randomization, that's basically putting individuals from within the sample into the treatment or control slash placebo group. So we can do that through tossing a coin. We can do that in various different ways. Ah, forgot to mention the fact that what we want is we want the treatment group to be similar to the control group except for the treatment. Outcome data is typically the presence or absence of disease, so which means categorical. But it could be measurement as well. So we either observe, and that's observed too, and survey is another possibility. So remember data collection methods. And there's various complicated ways of collecting data, as you'll see when you read some of the research that we're going to look at this semester. Compliance. What's compliance? Compliance, as I said, means basically did you do what you were supposed to do in the study. So if you were supposed to take a treatment, take a pill, or show up to get some other kind of treatment, did you show up? If you did, great. If you didn't, then your data should be considered missing data. Okay. So, non-compliance diminishes study power, so that's the ability to detect improvement, let's say. That's an example of what study power has to do with, and internal validity is connected with that. And reduced sample size as well. That's part of it. How to prevent people not complying? Designing a good study. And so there's some tips for that. And during the study, if you start, people start not complying, you can't really switch your protocol to account for that. Blinding. Blinding means subjects do not know if they are receiving treatment or placebo. Double blind means neither subjects nor investigators know who's receiving the treatment or placebo. The reason is to avoid bias. So that means extraneous factors practical significance. If outcome is categorical, you've seen this already, so relative risk is one, risk difference is another. That's if the outcome is categorical. If outcome is measurement, we compare means. Mean of treatment, mean of control. Or actually, more accurately, and I will, and it should be X bar for treatment, X bar for a control group, and X bar treatment. So you're comparing the treatment. So if you remember that, it's raw difference, which is X bar treatment minus X bar control. And doing the percent difference in Cohen's D, so we did that already. And that's just a very quick overview and a little bit of extra kind of information and language of the experiments.